The first question is how to access Primavera. After installing Primavera, go to Start, Programs, Primavera, and Primavera Project Planner. Click over it. It is the main window of Primavera Project Planner. Now let's add a new project. There are many ways to add a new project. First of all, press on this new icon or go to File and click on New, or simply type Ctrl plus N. Let me click over the new icon. Okay, add a new project. Dialog box appears. We have to start a project, so let me assume the project name is Home. Let me change it to House. Remember that the maximum characters in project name you can enter are 4, not more than 4. Its version is 1 and project title is Construction of a House. Let the company name is SGA Group of Contractors. The planning unit is Day. But for mechanical engineers it's R, as we are doing a project of civil engineering, so let me modify it today. Work days per week are 6 and week start on Monday. Project start date is okay. A calendar is opened. Remember that these two double arrows are used to change the year, while these two single arrows are used to change the month. So let me choose 1st July 2008. Click on OK and the project must be finished by 28th February 2010. Decimal places are 2, it's okay. Now click on Add. So a new window is opened. You can see that all these menus, these are known as main menus, are disabled. To enable these menus, press the escape key of your keyboard. Now we are going to add the activity ID codes. So go to Data and click on Activity Codes. There, click on Activity IDs. To enter the codes, click on plus icon and type face. Here again, the maximum length is, the maximum number of characters you can enter are 4. Press Enter. Keep length 1. Highlight the description and type the complete spelling of face. Again press enter or click on check. Okay, the number you enter in the length column will be equal to the number of characters you are going to add in the values. As it is here in this case, we have entered 1. So here the maximum character in the values column will be 1. So click over it. Save structure edits, yes. Now the first is D, press enter and its description will be design face. Again press enter and its order will be 1. Means it's on top priority. Next value is C. Press enter. Click on the right arrow of your keyboard and type description of C, which is construction phase. Again press enter and its order will be 2nd. Now the third value will be F, which stands for finishing phase. Press enter and it will be on 3rd priority. Now click on activity codes. Activity codes, let me highlight the last one and delete them one by one. You can delete by click on this minus icon or just by pressing the delete key of your keyboard. Leave the responsibility as we have to add the values of it. So responsibility, and change its length to 2. Remember that less the number of characters in the values, in name, in length, in description, the more efficient Primavera will work. Click on add, save structure edits, yes. So the first responsibility is of owner. Press enter. Press the right arrow of your keyboard and then type the description owner. Again press enter and its order will be 1st. 2nd is architectural, AR, enter, and its description is architect. It will have 2nd priority. The 3rd is contractor. And it will be on 3rd priority. Now close it and this data will be automatically saved. You can confirm. You can see that all the data is saved. It's nice. Now let me save the project. There are two ways of saving. Either you can press the save layout icon or press Ctrl S of your keyboard. Let me give it title as Shinwari. Click on save. So this activity is now saved. One thing you must remember, that unlike other Microsoft projects, this software has no undo command. You can see in view or edit, there is no undo command, or either if you press Ctrl Z, it will be of no use. So be aware, if you have done a mistake, there is no way to back, and except you have to do your work again. So that's the end of the first tutorial. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.